remember you guys had listened to, well, Zoc, you came up with the idea for some of the places I know, but the first time I heard it was lying on our couch in the jam room, and you guys played like a rough demo. I think you two might have worked up. The first thing that struck me straight away was the main riff, which was all on piano, and as soon as I heard that riff, like, within first 3 seconds of that riff, I was just like, that is the $1 million riff right there. That is amazing. I think it's probably my favorite riff, and I say this on every album because These Days was my favorite riff you'd ever come up with. But some of the places I know, that guitar, that piano riff and guitar riff at the start of that is amazing. I think we spent more time on that song for this record than any other song.
It was something really new and fresh and exciting for us. So, and even now, the way it went down on the album, I'm just really proud of it. It's quite an epic song, and I really look forward to listening to it in amongst all the really quite heavy rock songs.
Well, that song's come like 360. We did, when we took it to Gil, we went to town on it.
Gil kept pushing us away and away from the demo that we had. And I remember thinking in my head going, man, I just love the demo, I don't really want to change it. And we tried so many different things.
Essentially it was the funky guitar because it sounded too Chili Peppers or something when we had it.
The thing is that the thing we didn't want to do and what Gil kept saying is we didn't want to sound like white dudes trying to play punk.
Yeah. And it did.
To Gil it was like, he's like all worried about, don't get too funky boys, don't get too funky. And we're like, see, me and Zoc the whole time, we knew that it was never going to be funk.
Going to be no punk in a gyroscope.
Yeah, when we started this band, there was like one rule, no funk.
But you know what though,
I've bought that rule.
It's just that hook, like for me, once the hook came out, you know, just building some chords around it and stuff, and most of the, you know, the drum beat was quite simple but quite grooving, you know, just it reminded me a lot of like a good Ian Brown song where there's not like a million different things going on, you've just got this one hook and they repeat it and they do different things with it, and then I thought the music was really cool and really chilled, and then once I heard Dan's vocals on the song, I was just really, you know, it was instantaneously my new favourite song, you know. I thought Dan did a great job with the vocals, the music was really cool.
Hey, like it did change once you got rid of the piano, once that Mark Knopfler guitar came on in the verse, yeah. that's when I first heard that, I was like, because then my vocals could be funky and weird.
It's still quite a heavy song, you still got a little bit of strings in there, you got a little bit of piano, so it is quite epic-y in a sense. And I think it still fits the record because it isn't really like, you know, too mellow or too soft or anything, so.
Epic-y. I like that.
Epic-y.
Epic-y. Coined by Zoran Trivi. Epic-y. Epic-y.